Let's solve a real-life application problem that involves factoring a sum using the greatest common factor. There are 30 pencils and 20 pens to make gift bags. Each bag must contain the same number of pencils and pens with no leftovers. How many bags are there, and what is in each bag? Because there are 30 pencils and 20 pens, let's represent this as 30 plus 20, and now I'll factor this sum by factoring out the greatest common factor. To determine the greatest common factor, we'll look at the prime factorization of 30 and 20. For 30, let's start with 5 times 6, where 5 is prime. 6 is equal to 2 times 3, both 2 and 3 are prime. The prime factorization of 30 is 2 times 3 times 5. For 20, let's start with 2 times 10, where 2 is prime. 10 equals 2 times 5, both 2 and 5 are prime. The prime factorization of 20 is 2 times 2 times 5. To identify the greatest common factor, we circle the prime factors in common between 30 and 20. Notice 30 and 20 have one factor of 2 in common and one factor of 5 in common. This indicates the greatest common factor of 30 and 20 is 2 times 5, which is 10. And now I'll go back up to the sum of 30 and 20 and write 30 and 20 as products using the greatest common factor of 10, meaning we'll write 30 as 10 times 3 and 20 as 10 times 2. In this form, we will factor out the greatest common factor of 10. Notice if we factor out 10 from both 30 and 20, we're left with the sum of 3 and 2. 30 plus 20 is equal to 10 times the sum of 3 and 2. And now we interpret the factored form to answer the question. The 10 indicates how many gift bags there are, which was the greatest common factor. The 3, which came from the factor of 30, indicates how many pencils are in each gift bag. And the 2, which came from the factor of 20, indicates the number of pens in each bag. So there's a total of 10 gift bags, where each gift bag contains 3 pencils and 2 pens. I hope you found this helpful.